Hello everyone. Today, the organizers of the World Summit on Management Sciences, presenters, attendees, and listeners. I am Chioma George Anokwu. I'm going to speak on the economic globalization and growth of the Nigerian economy. Globalization means the speed up of movements and exchange of goods. Services, technologies, human beings, as well as capital all over the world. And one of the effects of globalization is that it promotes and increases interactions between regions and populations around the world. That means is globalization if properly managed, then the entire world benefits from globalization. The aim of the study is to determine the impact of globalization on economic growth in Nigeria from 1981 to 2019. We have the specific objectives, which include to determine the effects of imports, exports, and foreign direct investments on gross domestic products. Several authors have looked at the effects of globalization on gross domestic products. Some of the authors, their findings reveal that globalization has differential impacts in countries across the world. The benefits of globalization are, however, dependent on whether the country is developed or emerging, and or whether the naturally endowed resources are being optimally utilized for the purpose of diversification. Some of the findings also reveal that globalization has negative effects on the Nigerian manufacturing sector in the long run, while it has a positive effect in the short run. Another study also that examined the impact of globalization on the stock market in Africa revealed that globalization through foreign direct investment has significant and positive effects on stock markets in Africa. For the purpose of this paper, the auto-regressive distributed lag co-integration technique is preferable when dealing with variables that are integrated of different order, order 0, order 1, or combination of both orders. The model is specified in a log linear form in order to put the variables on the same scale. We have the GDPR, which represents the gross domestic product. The IMP represents imports. EXPT represents exports. FDI represents the foreign direct investment. So we have the GDP as a dependent variable and IMP, EXP, FDI as the independent variables. We have the results. We conducted the augmented degree lattice results, of course, to show the stationarity and non-stationarity of the variables. From the results here, you can see that the foreign direct investment is integrated of order zero, while the imports and exports were all integrated of order zero. And we proceed to conduct the co-integration test results. From the co-integration test results, you can also see that the F statistic is greater than the critical value bound for the upper bound. Therefore, we conclude that there is co-integration. And we proceed to estimate the long run and short run dynamics. Having the short-run dynamics, you can see from the result that imports is negatively related to GDP. You can see the value of the imports is showing a negative sign, is negatively related to GDP in the short run, and of course, it has a significant impact on growth. You can also see from the results that the exports is positive. It's positively related to GDP, and it's also significant. Now, this shows that exports increase growth of the Nigerian economy by 10.98%. The foreign direct investment, you can also see here that it has a negative relationship to GDP in the short run. Now, looking at the long run result, you can see here that exports is positively related to GDP and is also significant. And then the foreign direct investment is not significant in explaining the changes in growth rates. We also proceed to do the post-estimation test results And you can see from the result that the estimated ALGL model passed all the tests and, of course, is fit for policy recommendation. Of course, during the course of the work, we have some limitations. The data was not available as I went due, as I went expected, so it kind of delayed the work. That was one of the challenges we had in the course of the study. Based on the results and the findings, we conclude that there's existence of long-run relationship among variables which are specified in the model. Then the export promotes economic growth, while the import and foreign direct investment are not effective in driving economic growth in Nigeria. You can see that from the results. The findings, however, show that Nigeria is not yet enjoying the full benefits of globalization. We need to enjoy the full benefits of globalization. But this study reveals that Nigeria is not yet enjoying the full benefits of globalization. And based on the findings, we also recommend that the authorities in Nigeria should formulate and implement policies that reduce the level of imports into the country. We can see here that the exports exert a significant influence on GDP, so there should be more exports. And of course, if there's more exports, it means that the level of imports should reduce. We also recommend that authorities should provide sound macroeconomic policies that will create a stable and conducive environment for investment and economy to strive in Nigeria. Because when we have such conducive environment, it will boost investment. And of course, if it does, then FGI will also help benefits and help to the growth of the economy. Thank you all for listening. Thank you.